Ever since I got bit by that spider, I've only had 1 week where my life has felt normal. That was when you found out.
When you botched that spell where you wanted everyone to forget the Peter Parker Spider-Man, we started getting some visitors. From every universe.
Hello, Peter.
You're not Peter Parker.
I'm sorry, what was your name again?
Dr. Otto Octavius.
Wait, no, seriously, what's your actual name?
There are others out there. We need to send them back. So,
Scooby-Doo this crap.
You know, all this is kind of your mess. I know a couple of magic words myself, starting with the word please.
Please, Scooby-Doo this crap.
You're flying out into the darkness to fight ghosts.
What do you mean?
They all die fighting Spider-Man. It's their fate. I'm sorry, kid.
Yeah, me too.
Don't.
Look, there has to be another way.
There isn't. They're a danger to our universe.
You're not gonna take this away from me.
Peter, you're struggling to have everything you want while the world tries to make you choose.
It's all my fault. I can't save everyone.
What's happening?
They're starting to come through, and I can't stop them.
December 17th, exclusively in movie theaters. Tickets on sale November 29th. Spider Monday.
If you stray outside the designated areas, you will be removed from the island.
It's recommended you wear a hijab when visiting your client. We've had incidents of inmates spitting at female lawyers.
You want to represent the head recruiter for 9/11.
Mohamedou Ould Slahi, the Mauritanian held in Guantanamo. He recruited the guys who flew your friend's plane into the South Tower.
He put those men on my husband's plane?
I'm gonna make him pay.
In the event the detainee lunges for you, push back away from the table. We'll get in there as quick as we can.
Nancy Hollander, this is my associate. We wish to represent you.
We are seeking the death penalty, but if we miss something, this guy goes home. Let's get to it.
Call this number. Speak to my mother. Tell her, I don't know, something nice.
The U.S. government is holding upwards of 700 prisoners in Guantanamo. Since when did we start locking people up without a trial in this country?
That's a lot of case files.
The prosecution won't show us the evidence they have against you. It's all redacted.
You got a problem? Take it up with the government.
All my time here, I've been told you are guilty. Not for something that I have done, but because of suspicions and associations. I am innocent.
He has been interrogated. He has been held against his will for 6 years without a single charge being laid against him.
Doesn't it bother you at all working for someone like this?
I'm not just defending him. I'm defending the rule of law.
You haven't seen what I've seen.
Where I'm from, in Mauritania, we know not to trust the police. But never did I believe that the United States of America would use fear and terror to control me.
A couple of sleepless nights, that's all. I've never been part of a conspiracy, but I'm starting to think this is what it must feel like to be on the outside of it.
You're ever thinking this, either wear the jersey or get off the field.
You need to tell me what happened to you. I can't defend you. Do you understand that?
You asked me to set fire to this place, but I'm still standing.
Maybe he's guilty.
Maybe he is. But we're doing our job.
I'm not welcome home. That's not a part of my job.
If I'm wrong, when it comes to my record, and I'm the one that'll have to answer for it.
What makes you think you're any better than the rest of us?
I don't think I'm better than anybody else. That is the point.
For 8 years, I have been dreaming of being in a courtroom. Now that I'm here, I'm scared to death.
You know, I think I figured out why they built Guantanamo down there. My client, he's not a suspect. He's a witness.
Mr. Slahi, would you please raise your right hand and repeat after me?
The Mauritanian.
Heroes. It's an old-fashioned notion.
A visionary. A genius. Ensuring freedom around the globe.
A symbol to the nation. A hero to the world.
The beacon of hope. Shining out across the stars.
I look around at us, you know what I see?
A bunch of a-holes.
Possibility. You think you know how the world works?
The world is changing.
We need heroes.
Strength invites challenge. Challenge incites conflict. Conflict breeds catastrophe. The thing isn't beautiful because it lasts.
Before we're done, we still have one promise to keep. If you can't protect the Earth, you can be damn sure we'll avenge it. Whatever it takes.
Sounds like work.
No, tell them I'm in my chair.
Yes, he's just walked in.
This is unexpected. I can't believe I'm actually having lunch with spies. I'm just a salesman.
Exactly. You're a civilian, so the KGB won't be watching.
It would be a real service to Great Britain.
What would you want me to do?
I'm here to open a door to the top manufacturers in the West.
Would I be putting myself in danger?
If this mission was the least bit dangerous, you really are the last man we'd send.
Make sure you wear it while you're in Moscow.
What does this do? Shoot poison darts?
Everyone you meet assume they're KGB. Every Russian is an eye of the state.
You'll just be a courier.
Just a courier? For Russian secrets? From now on, you will be selling one thing. The idea that you are an ordinary businessman and nothing more than an ordinary businessman.
weapons of war must be abolished before they abolish us.
I am asking you to stop going to Moscow. I am asking you as your wife.
I didn't want you to be involved.
What if I get caught? Then execute me, correct?
We can't get him out. If things were the other way around, Penkovsky would abandon you.
He would never leave me to die, and I'm not leaving him. I'm volunteering to bring back the best source of Soviet intelligence you got at a time where Russia and America are on the brink of nuclear war.
Maybe we're only two people, but this is how things change.
Welcome to another edition of Between Two Ferns, and my guest today is Matthew McConaughey.
Good to be here, Zach.
Of all the things you can win an Oscar for, how surprised are you that you won one for acting?
Here we go.
I noticed that you're wearing a shirt. Is everything okay?
And you have a major leak in here.
I'm so sorry.
Let's see what's going on with these pipes.
Dude, don't do that.
Well, they turned the sprinklers off.
You killed Matthew McConaughey.
He's dead?
He's brought back to life, but he was momentarily dead. You owe me.
Go across the country, get 10 more episodes of Between Two Ferns.
10, your dumb internet talk show, and you give me a network talk show. I'm a white man, and I'm straight, and I deserve it. Green as ever. Is the width off to you? We're taking Between Two Ferns on the road. My guest today is Benedict Cumberbatch.
Benedict Cumberbatch.
That's what it is. I read online that you're very private and declined to answer questions that make you feel uncomfortable. Is that true? And how old were you when you got your first period? Bradley Cooper co-wrote, directed, and starred in A Star Is Born.
I hear it's great.
Are you hoping that will open doors for other hot idiots? I don't know if I'm going to get these shows out. We don't have any money. We're hungry. We're going to order the clam strips.
How big are they?
Have you ever seen a chicken strip?
I've never seen a chicken wear clothes.
Here's to the crazy ones. The misfits. And ding dongs.
I'm just curious about the pathology behind this.
Some people would say we're the crazy ones, but I think we're geniuses. Hello.
I love your show.
What if we take this upstairs?
What about John Legend?
He's probably at home polishing his EGOT.
Is that what he calls his penis?
Between Two Ferns, the movie. Is it going to be in theaters? Not in theaters.